if there's one person who's watching right now and they feel like, you know, I'm not big enough, I'm a small business owner, but I want to do it, you know, not today, not tomorrow, but I want to go jump in on YouTube. So what can you tell them? You know, what do they need to prepare? What's the first thing that they need to do before they jump in and be on YouTube on their first episode?
Yeah, that's a really good question. And I think it's actually really important. And what I would say to anybody who's thinking about starting a channel, especially if you're a small business, is I see and hear a lot of people say, you know, that's just too expensive, can't afford to hire a crew. Or maybe they're like, the technology is too complicated. Both of those things nowadays are myths. And so honestly, I think if you're a small entrepreneur, you can't afford not to do video marketing in this day and age. And that's going to save your business. I think in the next 10, 15 years, video is going to be huge, right? And if you aren't on video, it's going to be kind of like you don't exist. Just like if you're not on the internet now and you don't have a website, you don't exist, right? Yes. But the thing is, the barrier to entry is so much lower now. There's lots of room for amateurs and kind of this authentic reality kind of based way of looking at the world is kind of in right now. So the whole idea that everything you do has to be all polished and, you know, all of that, right? It has to be scripted by a professional, all that kind of stuff is not as important as it maybe was 10 years ago. And the technology too, there's amazing technology out there now that's really easy to learn. Mm-hmm. So you know, if you're a small entrepreneur right now and you're thinking, overwhelming, can't do it, that'd be the first thing that I would say is that both of those issues are off the table at this point in the world. Yes. But I do think that if you're a small business owner, I'm a solo business owner, right? I'm doing everything. Then you do have to be really intentional about your planning process. And I get really intentional about my process. If you just think to yourself, I'm going to try to do some video marketing. If I have time, I'll, you know, maybe dig out my camera, do a few things. That's going to fail. It's doomed to fail. Because you know how this goes. You're a small business owner, the phone rings, somebody needs something, and all of a sudden your day is over and you haven't done half the things that you thought you were going to do today, right? The days will just get away from you unless you really protect your time. And so I think that if you're going to go in and do video marketing, that you really need to commit to it. You need to say, yes, I need this, and I'm going to make a commitment that I'm going to make it happen, whether that's one video a month, whether it's I'm just starting out doing some little short things on Instagram, you know, whatever your deal is, that you make a commitment that you're going to be consistent with it. And then the second thing that I would say is that you also want to think about the fact that your return on investment for video marketing has a really long tail on it. So if somebody is thinking, I'm going to just put a couple videos out on YouTube and boom, my business is going to explode overnight. That's also not true. Mm-hmm. It's a long tail curve, right? Yes. And so you need to think about the cost and the time that you're starting with, right? You have to, that in the short term, that's going to hurt. But in the long term, 3 years from now, you know, or whenever, and the views come in and you're building your expertise online and your authority, that's going to really help you out. So those are just a couple things that I would say. If you're thinking of starting a video marketing strategy, think about those things, you know, plan ahead for those. But then I would encourage you to do it, because I was reading on Forbes not too long ago, and they were saying that by 2022, that online videos are going to make up more than 82% of all consumer internet traffic. So, I mean, you need to be on video. There's just no two ways about it.
Yeah, I mean, you got that figure right, because I've read that as well. They have that, you know, prediction. These people have data, and they have, you know, they have data to support their claims that, you know, by next 2022, there's going to be 82%. So if you're not part of that, but on a practical, I think on a practical side of things, when people ask me, like, you know, what will it take me? You know, that's the magic question for them. I always tell them, you know, there's no rule of thumb. You know, there's no like magic pill that you're going to swallow and then, like, you know, in 1 week, in 2 weeks, I'm good at this. And they really have to, you know, start. But practically, I would tell my students or the people I'm coaching is, you need at least a year of, like, you know, a minimum of 1 year dedication that I'm really going to do this week by week, you know, find a way to insert myself. Like you said, if it's going to be Instagram first or it's going to be, you know, YouTube stories, but that would help me, you know, my confidence in talking in front of the camera. They would probably see stories as, you know, small thing. But I think the big impact for that is it helps you, it helps your confidence grow, you know, because there's a camera in front of you. People would think it's easy. Like, I think you're scripting your videos. Me, I'm scripting that. But the confidence to be in front of the camera, I don't know if you have experienced this. Like, I have video production projects, so my client was, like, you know, all confident and stuff. Once I hit the record, it's like they were possessed by, you know, a quiet spirit. They can, I don't know. There's something about the light, you know, the red light blinking and the lens pointing at you that would really kill a person. So, I mean, yeah, you're right. You know, it's look at what you're gonna attack first. For me, the very first concern is your confidence. That's it. You know, even if you're a good writer, you know, you have very good skill set, but your confidence is not showing in front of the camera. That's the first thing that you need to work on, you know. And I think minimum of a year, you can safely say after a year, I'm confident, you know, enough to bring my game to the next level, right?